Hello, beautiful people. This is 11th of January. It's the birthday of Ányos István Jedlik. Haven't heard the name, right? Stay hooked on. The things I tell you will certainly ring a bell. But before we get into that, make sure to hit the subscribe button and click the bell icon so you never miss a video. If you like my work, hit the like button. Something to tell me? Leave it in the comments box below. Now let's get back. In 1827, Jedlik started experimenting on electromagnetic rotating devices, and he called them lightning magnetic self rotors. In 1828, he came up with the first practical DC motor. It had three components: the stator, the part that does not rotate; the rotor, the part that rotates; and commutator, the part that is responsible for switching the current periodically between the rotor and the external circuit. Now, that's that, but he did not mention it before 1856, and that's the reason Siemens gets the credit. But the thing that he invented is still preserved in the Museum of Applied Arts in Budapest, and it still works today. Now, in 1861, around 1861, he also discovered the possibility of self-excitation. Now, let me tell you what that is. See, I told you stators are the parts that does not rotate. Their responsibility is to provide magnetic field around the rotor. This could be achieved in two ways. If we could use a permanent magnet or an electromagnet. But if we use an electromagnet, it has to be fed some kind of power. It could be from an external source, or the power that is being generated from the rotor is fed into the stator. If the power from the rotator is used to create the magnetic field in the stator, that thing is called self-excitation. So if you use a self-excitation dynamo, you first start the generator without a load circuit, and slowly the circuit builds up to full voltage. How? First, the voltage is low, but the power that is being generated enhances the magnetic field from the stator, and that increases the power output, and that further enhances the magnetic field, which further ups the output, and so it reaches a peak voltage, and then the load circuit is applied. Now, he discovered this possibility around 1861, 6 years before Siemens and Wheatstone did. Two inventions so far, more coming. Around 1863, he also discovered the possibility of voltage multiplication, and he demonstrated it in 1868 using tubular voltage generators. What are these? These things are similar to impulse generators, and impulse generators are things that produce short-lived high voltage or current surge. If it's a voltage surge that it produces, it's called an impulse voltage generator, and it's used for testing of electrical components or in nuclear research. And if it's a current surge that it produces, it's called an impulse current generator, and that thing is used in testing of electrical components again, and in lasers and thermonuclear research again. So this is a pretty big stuff, let it be for now. To do this, he used a thing called condenser, and these things are similar to modern day capacitors. And also, he used a method called cascade connection, which is very fundamental, and it is supposed to be one of his greatest discoveries. And he demonstrated this whole thing in the Vienna World Expo in 1873. Now let me tell you more about cascade connection, which is his fourth discovery after the tubular voltage generators. Now, cascade connection is something very fundamental. You have low voltage, you want big voltage, you use an amplification circuit. Now, if the amplification circuit by itself isn't powerful enough to take the low voltage that you are supplying and give out the high voltage that you need, then what he did is cascade connection. And the very idea is using the circuits with low amplification factor. That means you take the voltage, a fraction of the required output is generated, which is further fed into another amplification circuit, and it is further amplified to a greater voltage, and so on until the required voltage is achieved. This method of cascade connection is used even today in amplifiers. That's it for today. Have a nice day. Keep loving physics.